So today we are going to estimate the amount of our reducing sugar by Nelson-Somogyi method. We are having our unknown glucose solution, standard glucose solution, distilled water, alkaline copper tartrate solution, and arsenomolybdate solution. These are our reagents. First of all, we are going to take our standards. We have taken input as 0.2, 0.4, 0.6. So I take my first input, 0.2. 0.2 into standard reducing sugar. Next is 0.4. Then we have to add 0.6 and 0.8. So now we are done with our standards. We have taken aliquot as 0.2, 0.4, 0.6, 0.8. Now we will take our unknown solution of 0.2 and 0.4 aliquot. So now we are done with the aliquots of standard and unknown. Now we have to make the level of all our tubes to 1 and 2 ml with distilled water. Now we have made all the tubes with the final volume of 2 ml. All are having 2 ml. Now we have to add our reagent alkaline copper tartrate solution. What it does is our copper tartrate solution has cupric in it. This cupric is going to react with our reducing sugar, and our reducing sugar is going to reduce it to cuprous oxide. We have to add 2 ml of copper tartrate to every tube. So what it will do is, it will convert our cupric ions to cuprous oxide. And that cuprous oxide is going to react with our second reagent, which is arsenomolybdate. Then when cuprous oxide is going to react with arsenomolybdate, it's going to give us a color, molybdenum blue. And that color, with that color concentration, we can estimate the amount of our unknown reducing sugar concentration. So right now what we are doing is, when we add our copper tartrate, all our copper ion is going to convert into cuprous oxide. That cuprous oxide will react with our arsenomolybdate. So now we are done with 2 ml of our reagent to each of our tubes. Now we have to incubate these tubes in the boiling water bath for 10 minutes. Now in this way we are going to add arsenomolybdate solution to all the tubes, and after that we are going to incubate all the tubes at room temperature for 10 minutes. Now this way we are going to add our reagent in all the tubes, 2 ml. So we can see after adding the arsenomolybdate reagent we got this color. We can see that from bland to our standard 1 ml, the color intensity is increasing as we have increased the concentration of the reducing sugar. Now we will take the reading of all these tubes at 620 nanometer, and by plotting the graph of standards, we can calculate the concentration of unknown solution of the reducing sugar, the concentration of reducing sugar.